Can my school see the email I send and receive? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. If I send an email from my personal account to another person's school account, will my school be able to see it? So I'm going to assume you're both in the same school and that by your personal account, you're using some kind of an account off-site, maybe a Gmail or a Outlook.com or some other kind of account. There's really only one safe assumption to make, and that is, yes, your school can see the email that travels across its network. If that school, if your recipient is in the same school you are, then yeah, you've got to assume they can see it. Unless you've taken some specific precautions, of course, absolutely the school can see everything that travels across its network. Let's examine that and what those special precautions might be. Remember that when you're using your school's network, when you're using your school's equipment, be that you or your recipient, the school is acting as the ISP. They are providing the internet service. That in turn implies they can see everything you do. ISPs can in fact see what you are doing. They can see that you're sending mail. They can typically see what mail is you're sending. They can see what services you're using. They can do almost everything you might want them not to do. Now, when we talk about outside email to your school, again, it doesn't matter that you're outside of the school. The fact that you're sending email to a recipient within the school, they may not be able to see what you're doing in your outside email sending service, but they can see what your friend receives. They can see what your recipient is getting and who they're getting it from. So in that sense, in that very real sense, you are exposing what you've sent to your school. Now, the question is, does your school actually do this? I have no idea. I really don't. In fact, I expect the answer to vary dramatically depending on what school you're at, what kind of a history it has, what kind of information technology savvy they happen to have on board, whether they even know how to do this kind of thing. Absolutely, I would expect some schools to do it. You bet. I would probably expect most schools not to, or perhaps putting another way, I would expect most conversations not to be monitored, even if the school is monitoring some. Because it's just too much work, right? I mean, they have more important things to do generally than monitor what's flowing across their network. It's not that they aren't, they could be. And that's really where you need to go. The only safe assumption is that indeed they are monitoring what you're sending and receiving, what you're doing online. So what does that mean? I talked about precautions you can take. There are really only a couple. One, of course, is that don't use school equipment. And I mean that on both sides of the conversation, right? I mean, both you and your friend should simply go elsewhere, should not use the school's equipment for whatever it is you're attempting to do. If it doesn't travel across the school's network, they can't see it. It's just not an issue. So if your friend has a Gmail account and you have a Gmail account, great, you're done. You're not going to go through the school's equipment because you're not going to do this at school. You would do it at home or off your phone or whatever. That's a special issue too, right? If you have a mobile phone or some other portable device and you are using your school's network, maybe you connect to your school's Wi-Fi while you're at school, even if it's a portable device, they can still see what you're up to. They can still monitor the traffic going across that connection. That's why I keep referring to, or I keep saying, not using the school's equipment. Don't use their computers, don't use their services, don't use their networks. As long as you avoid all of that, you'll sidestep their ability to monitor anything. The only other scenario that I think would be somewhat interesting to investigate if both of you are up to it is to use encrypted mail. If you use some form of encrypted email, which I will tell you is not necessarily easy, the school might be able to see that you are communicating with someone, but they will not be able to see the contents of the message. And that's ultimately what I think you're looking for here. But by far, the safer thing to do if you have any questions, any concerns, is avoid the school's equipment completely. And again, I have to reiterate, this is about a lot more than just email. Whatever you're downloading, whatever game you're playing, whatever websites you're visiting, whatever services you're using online, if you're doing it through your school's equipment, they could see it. I don't know that they are, but they could. And I also have to point out that this is about a lot more than just school. Everything that I've just said, literally everything, applies just as equally to the workplace. In other words, if you're using your workplace's equipment, be it computers, network, or services, then by definition, they can, and in fact, in most cases, have the legal right to see whatever it is you're doing. If that's a concern, all I can say is don't do it. Use alternate services to do whatever it is you're attempting to do. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/136731. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.